How's it going, guys? I am Connor from Running Warehouse, and welcome to our global running shoe review of the Hoka Carbon X2. With an all-new design from top to bottom, the Carbon X2 received some pretty substantial updates that continue to make it a phenomenal performance trainer that also has some longer distance racing capabilities. Now weighing in at 8.5 ounces for a men's size 9, the shoe comes in a little lighter than its predecessor while also offering added stack height for a more cushioned underfoot feel. Finished off with a rigid carbon fiber plate, the Carbon X2 continues to maintain several of the key philosophies that helped Jim Walmsley set the 50-mile road world record. All right, I'm gonna be the first one up on this review, and let me just start out by saying I've been testing this shoe out for almost a year now. I was lucky enough to help out with the development of the shoe, and I've tested it out for a wide variety of workouts and training runs, and I'm gonna break this shoe down from top to bottom. Now, starting off with the midsole, we've got a big slab of ProFly X cushioning. Now, it's 2 millimeters higher than the last version, and when you get this shoe on foot, it does feel more cushioned. It feels very protective, can go almost any distance. Now, we've got the ProFly X cushioning, and what that basically means is it's a fancy term Hoka uses for their latest EVA compound. I don't know exactly what it is, but it's not a PEBA-based foam. It does still give a nice pop. It feels very protective, and for a performance trainer, it was everything that I needed. It was highly durable, and the first pair of these shoes I had, I got close to 400 miles, so they can definitely go the distance. Now, that high stack height is gonna work with the carbon fiber plate. Same carbon fiber plate we saw in version 1. It's really gonna create that rigid experience. Not much flex to this shoe, and again, that's what we see in a lot of these carbon fiber plate shoes, and it helps with that efficiency story. When I got this shoe on foot and going through the stride, it feels smooth, a lot smoother than the first version. I think the ride has been improved a lot coming out here into version 2. Moving on down to the outsole, we're gonna see a very similar design to the last version. We've got a thin layer of rubberized foam, and that's just gonna help create a little bit of pop, help keep weight down. And I know a lot of people were worried that it isn't gonna have enough traction, but I don't think that's gonna be the case. Would I use it for trails? Would I use it for wet surfaces? Probably not, but for me, it had everything I needed when I was picking up the pace on the roads. Now, finishing this shoe off, we've got an all new upper design. When I got it on foot, very breathable, and the first thing I noticed was there's a little bit more volume than some of the other carbon fiber plate shoes on the market. In the midfoot, there's a little bit of room, and then especially in the toe box, lots of room for toe splay. So again, a little bit different of a feel than some of the elite marathon racers out there. Of course, you got the flared heel. When I got this on my foot, very comfortable. I did have to adjust the laces because there was a little bit of wiggle room in the heel. Once I adjust the laces, it felt good and really offered a nice, comfortable on-foot experience. Now, I think this is gonna fit a wider variety of runners. If you do have a wider foot, and maybe aren't able to fit in some of the other carbon plated shoes, I think the Carbon X2 is gonna be a great option for you. Overall, I've had a fun time testing out the new Carbon X2, and I think it is a nice upgrade over its last version. It's highly cushioned, fairly lightweight, and offers an even smoother transition over the last version. I really think this shoe is a versatile performance shoe. I think some people will use it for race day. Some people are gonna use it for tempos, workouts. And what surprised me the most was it was a great option for steady long runs. I found myself easily getting under 7 minute pace, just felt effortless. So that's where I think I'm gonna use this shoe a lot in the future. But those were just my thoughts. Let's head on over to Germany and check in with our crew at Running Warehouse Europe. Celia, what were your thoughts on the Carbon X2?
Thanks, Connor. So yes, I really enjoyed running with the Carbon X2. It's a speed shoe, it's super light, well cushioned, very breathable, and also attractive from its design. But before talking about the design, let's dig into the fit and the performance. So something I noticed directly when I stepped in the shoe, it's the super performance-oriented fit that it offers, and it didn't vanish during my runs. So that's a really good point. It stayed great and consistent, which was not always the case with the previous version, and the laces tended to loosen up slightly. I enjoyed the snug fit at the midfoot, but I found the forefoot a little bit too wide and the upper a little bit too loose. Here, Hoka used a super thin mesh, which is also light, but on the other side, breathable and super sturdy. I was a little bit afraid to be too cold during chilly winter runs, but everything went fine. Now with this shoe, something I really noticed after a few strides, it's the energy return of the shoe. And it's even more dynamic when you run at a higher pace, so that's a super rewarding feeling. The carbon plate and the rocker design offer super smooth propulsion and an enjoyable ride. And this definitely helped me at the end of my longer runs. It gave me a nice boost when my legs were starting to feel a little bit tired. So I can say that the stiff carbon plate and the soft midsole pair up together really nicely. Now, talking about soles, the shoe isn't great off-road, but I must say I was really surprised by its performance, its stability, and forgiving performance on dirt and on mixed terrain. You have an ample cushioning and a wide base which offer a good protection underfoot and a good stability. Also on this second version of the Carbonix, the carbon plate has been moved towards the bottom of the shoe, so it gives you a softer feeling when you run. So for me, the Carbonix 2 ticked all the boxes in terms of comfort, but still you get nothing too soft, so at the end nothing slowing you down when you are racing or training. Now about the design of the shoe. I'm really a fan of this vibrant color, but I also liked the reflective insert on the tongue. It gives a sleek look and a little bit of contrast. Also, what's really nice with the Carbonix is the flare heel here behind. It helps to fit in the shoe, it prevents irritation, and it gives overall a really speedy look, performance look. So overall, I find this Carbonix 2 visually more attractive than the first version, and I can say that it's as fast as it looks. Now let's check with Running Warehouse Australia. Nath, what did you think about the Carbonix 2?
Thanks, Celia. So the Carbonix 2 is a shoe I've been really looking forward to checking out after running my maiden marathon in the original Carbonix. So join me for a bit of a run and I'll tell you my thoughts on the shoe. So in the midsole, I really enjoyed the Carbon X originally. I ran my first marathon in it and found it to be a pleasure underfoot. With the Carbon X 2, it's got even better. They've got that new foam. It's softened it up. It made it a little bit more lively underfoot. I'd say a little bit more responsive, really good for when I was running some sessions or a tempo day. In the upper, I really liked the original Carbon X upper, and this one is just as good, if not better. They've improved it, they've given a little bit more volume through the forefoot, which I think was a really good addition, but you can still get a good race day, session day, midfoot lockdown. In the heel, they've got that new swallowtail heel, or decoupled through the heel. Makes it a little bit more stable, and I think for anyone who's heel striking, it's going to make it really smooth underfoot. Up at the heel counter, the little elf tail heel counter, which they've added, I really like. It takes it away from your Achilles and it allows you to easily slip the shoe on and off. So as I said, I've run a marathon in the original Carbon X, and I think the Carbon X 2 is a really nice update to that. It's a little bit softer, plusher underfoot, and I enjoyed that extra comfort for recovering after my tempos or sessions that I have done in it. As I said, the upper, it's just got a little bit more volume to it, especially through that forefoot. I think it's just gonna make it that little bit more accommodating. All in all, it's a really nice shoe, something I would use for tempos or marathon session workouts. I'd probably go to something a little bit lighter for a race, but I think for some people, it's gonna be a really versatile shoe that you can do long runs, tempo runs, session, and even a marathon in.
So that was our global review of the Hoka Carbonix 2. You can find your own pair at Running Warehouse, Running Warehouse Europe, or Running Warehouse Australia.